Haspel. How you doing, my man?
I'm doing well, GK.
Randy and the Radiance. Boy, do we go far back.
We do.
Man. 706 Union.
Yes, absolutely.
Who produced your stuff down there?
Well, we worked at 639 Madison.
Oh, you didn't do the thing on Union?
No, they were already gone from there. We started recording with Mr. Phillips in 1964. Knox brought us in. Knox Phillips brought us in 1964. And he was in Madison by then. So we recorded our original stuff at the Madison studio. And we recorded an additional album a few years later in the old studio.
Did you get a good sound? And I heard the sound was not too great in there.
I didn't think so. I thought the drums sounded like cannon shots, you know. Yeah. But, you know, I'm not going to complain, George.
No, no,
cutting a record in the original song.
Yeah,
studio.
All of his kits were cut there, but the Chips had a problem with that too. And what he did when he cut there, when he cut Class of '55, uh-huh. all those guys, Roy Orbison and Jerry Lee and Johnny Cash, all those guys, he brought in that sound truck from Nashville.
Yeah.
And they rolled it up behind them, and they got pretty decent sound.
Yeah.
Randy, you got a CD. Tell us about the CD.
I do. This is a compilation of our Sun recordings, 1964, 1966, and it's on Ace Records Big Beat from the United Kingdom, and it's got 24 tracks on them, and I was just so happy. They liked our originals, and, you know, we were all 16, 17 years old.
Yeah.
So they gave us really the royal UK treatment on this, and I'm very happy with it, George. Of course,
good. What do you think was the best garage band when you were coming out? Who was happening?
Well, aside from us, you mean?
Yeah.
Now, our idols were. You don't know this, but I was with Flash. I helped start the Casuals.
I didn't know that.
I was one of the original Casuals.
Really?
And my parents grounded me because my grades were lousy, and Flash took over. For me, and then we started the Radiance. But our idols were always Tommy Burke and the Counts.
Yeah.
I always have to give credit. I used to go to their gigs with a notebook and take notes about what keys they were singing. I love that band.
Really?
And a couple of them have passed on now. And
he's still around.
Tommy's still around, absolutely.
Yeah.
Professor Tom Burke.
He's retired from CBC.
He called
over there.
He did.
He's
did
not
retire.
There anymore. I tried to reach him not too long ago. Randy of Randy and the Radiance, Randy Haspel. Randy, you write a thing for the Flyer, don't you?
Yes, I do. I write the rant every other week, and it's on the back page of the Flyer, and I alternate weeks with my friend Tim Sampson, who started the whole thing. You know, Tim works for the Stax Academy now. You need to get him on your show, too.
Yeah. Wasn't he with the local Grammy organization?
He is, yeah. So he started that. It's a funny column, but sometimes I get political, and sometimes I write lighthearted things, but I'm just happy that I can be appearing in print every couple of weeks.
Well, that's good exposure for you. Randy Haspel, you see, he's a songwriter, too, but he don't have to worry about a melody because she lives with him, right? Is that your wife, Melody?
It is, and she couldn't come. She sends her regards.
I heard a story. You wrote a song for George Jones.
I did.
All right, I heard a story before we went on the air today that you were driving from Nashville to Memphis,
right,
and the record came on the air, and you had to stop off the side of the road. Listen, is that true?
That is true. I wrote a song called Call the Wrecker for My Heart. And my fellow songwriters, I was up there trying to learn how to co-write.
Yeah.
And nobody wanted, they said, that's ridiculous. Nobody would write it with me. So I ended up writing it by myself, and I demoed it. I was working for a publisher, and they had a house band, and it was on a cassette. You remember those?
Oh yeah, I remember cassette. I remember 8 tracks.
And the first part of it played by accident when George Jones and his wife were listening.
Yeah.
And his wife Nancy said, "What's that?" And she liked the song, and so I got the George Jones cut.
At least you got a cut on the old possum.
I did, and when I was driving home, it came on the radio, and I couldn't stand myself. I had to pull over on the shoulder and go, "Yeah, call
well,
the record for my heart." You know,
Randy, how can they order this CD? It's a compilation of the old hits of Randy and the Radiance.
It's on Amazon. I think that's
Amazon.com,
the best place to look for.
Okay.
You
can get anything on my book. Went number one 2 weeks ago on there.
Well, congratulations,
I got lucky on that one. Randy, thanks for coming down, my man.
My pleasure.
melody, we said hello.
I will indeed.
Write me a hit song.
I'd love to.
Randy Haspel, Randy the Radiance, Memphis South with GK.